Well, I was a big fan of stand-up as a child. As a kid, I thought I wanted to be a stand-up, and then ended up going to drama school and pursuing acting more than that. More than, I mean, at all. I never pursued it. But had, you know, a love for stand-up and then just tried to pick apart, like, what the performance element is, you know, like how you control an audience, how you build something, how you, like, it's a magic trick, right? To me it is, at least. And the joy is partially in, like, the reveal and how you hide the trick and how you set someone up and how you, you know, like, that there's a seeming element of, oh, someone's just up there telling a story, but they've built it out for months or years to perfect how everything function so the audience is drawn to the laugh, you know?
Part of that building it up, though, I think is similar to dramatic acting as well, which is you're practicing it and you're practicing it in the way that you rehearse it, and you rehearse it so that when you get up there, it feels natural, that you're going through these motions and the reveal, but at the same time, like you said, it feels very natural, like someone's just up there talking.
Yeah, yes. In this case, yeah, I mean, in this case, you have a mix of, like, the performative element of being a stand-up in which you are on display, whereas in a, you know, a scene, you are trying to sort of, the fake is that it's just you and I in a room, that there isn't, like, a sound guy and a camera operator and a DP and all this stuff. So I guess I looked into or tested out, like, how to do that. We had a great young stand-up who was on the show, like, as a coach, essentially, to go through the material, just to give, like, pointers here and there. Simple stuff, like in that clip. Are we allowed to swear? Can I swear on this thing?
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Great. So, not that I'm, like, a, you know,
curse it up.
Problem cursor or whatever, but, you know, Nick, like, fucks up the mic stand and the thing, and that's like a full amateur move when you see guys like tug at the cable, like, just all the guys in the show are stand-ups were like, nobody does that, you look like an idiot. Like, that's the beginning when you see a guy who doesn't know how to hold a microphone, doesn't know what to do with the stand. Like, that's part of figuring it out. So to come onto the show as a guy who's supposed to, like, kind of be on the up, you have to get that stuff ironed out. You can't show up and start doing that and basically reveal that you're an actor bullshitting through pretending to be a stand-up. But in that scene in particular, Nick is newly sober, or at least trying to kick heroin, and blows it on stage, like, does not have the goods if he's not a little messed up on stage. And so that sort of amateurish, like, just doesn't know where he is in the world, comes through. And all of that is built out of understanding what a good stand-up would be doing and how to subvert that to tell a different story that's true to that world, you know, instead of just going up and bumbling around as if that will sell it well enough. And as far as the you know, addiction stuff, the simple answer would be like, oh, I, you know, experimented with a lot of drugs, which was not untrue in my...
one time.
Years ago. Not currently. I wasn't like, I'm going to get into smack just for this. You
tell that to the producers and the insurance company behind the shows.
Yeah. Jake, we're not doing a fifth season. Yeah, good. Fine.
So I'll kick smack now.
Yeah. Do you guys have any other heroin roles, or this was it? But really, that to me, like, the heroin is like this. The drug addiction is this impediment to. It's like a necessity and an impediment in Nick's life, in which he feels like he, as an actor. I want to find why he needs this and what he's missing in the world and what he wants most, which is probably like love and self-acceptance and compassion. And that, sadly for him, heroin is the only path that he's found to that.
Well, at
the same time,
it's
killing him.